the big one, a major earthquake on the San Andreas Fault. Often exaggerated in movies, but a real danger to Southern California. Nothing like what you see here, of course. And computer models suggest it would actually be even less of a threat to us in our corner of the state. For San Diegans, the Rose Canyon Fault system, running through our most populated areas, is the bigger concern. Though it hasn't had significant movement since European settlement, it is considered active, and has potential for a magnitude 6 or 7 quake. There's a new park on the eastern edge of downtown that owes its existence to a section of this fault.
Primarily going to put out energy.
Dr. Pat Abbott, geology professor at San Diego State University, recently took the director of the county's Office of Emergency Services, Holly Crawford, and assistant director, Stephen Ray, on a tour of the fault, which begins here at Fault Line Park.
So members of the public might see that there's a fault, obviously running right through this park, and then this huge high-rise building. What would you expect if you were maybe in the top of this building as opposed to one of these lower buildings across the street?
Well, you know, it's interesting because buildings have periods or frequencies of movement just like seismic waves do. Now, right here on this fault, that's the kind of seismic waves we're going to be getting are the real high frequency sorts of things. And they don't really bother the tall buildings like this that much. The kinds of seismic waves that are going to shake that building, that's the San Andreas Fault east of the Salton Sea. When that comes in with those rolling kinds of waves like we had on Easter 6 years ago, that's going to make that building, oh boy, that'll be quite an experience. Not for danger, but just, I mean, you're going to get a ride that you'll remember for the rest of your life.
If the Rose Canyon Fault goes, the big concern is the older unreinforced buildings and, in newer buildings, heavy objects falling on people. The proximity to the physical fault line is not as much of a concern, which is why we still see new buildings going up downtown.
You know, here's another one of these urban fault parks. We're here at First and Market Street, and this little nice little tree-filled park running between these buildings on this diagonal, this is another active fault that people have we cannot build on top of it because when the ground ruptures, it would break the building. But you know, interestingly enough, you know, when we look at the balconies, you say, well, golly, look, people are living right here, right next to the fault. Isn't that more dangerous? No, no, it's not. It doesn't really matter whether you're 50 feet or 5 miles away. Consider that the fault ruptures at 8 miles depth and the earthquake waves come straight up. It's about the same whether you're 5 miles away or you're right next to it. Kind of what's intuitive actually is not a problem. Being close is not a problem.
Moving out of downtown, we journey to the spot where the Rose Canyon Fault System first meets land in San Diego, just off the coast of La Jolla, a spot where you can see physical evidence of the power of an earthquake fault.
Well, we've come here to these beach cliffs in La Jolla Bay to view where a major fault comes on shore. You know, if we were up there in Orange County now, there'd be the Newport Inglewood Fault. In 1933, the Long Beach earthquake, 115 people dead, that exact same fault up there. Here it is coming ashore in San Diego, and it's beautifully shown in these cliffs behind us here. This is part of the Rose Canyon Fault system. This one's called the Country Club Fault, but it's part of the Rose Canyon Fault zone. And you can see two very different types of rocks juxtaposed against each other. When we look at the rocks over here on the east side of the fault, we see sandstones interbedded with a lot of mudstones, tilted a bit here by the fault action, but a lot of layered sedimentary rocks, mostly mudstone. If we swing around to the other side and look at the other side of the fault, here on the west side, massive thick sandstone beds, totally different rock layers. Here's the actual slippage along the fault surface. These rocks have moved maybe even as much as half a mile. Many, many major earthquakes occurred to separate these rocks. This isn't a one-time event. This is big earthquakes over and over and over again. These are landscape-shaping events. Faults like this are the reasons why we have Mount Soledad. If it wasn't for these faults, there would be no Mount Soledad. The whole landscape would be flat.
In fact, following the fault over Mount Soledad and down Interstate 5, we come to Tecolote Park, where, tucked into the back corner of the baseball fields, there stands a direct acknowledgement of this fault, perhaps the only one in the city.
We hear so much about the San Andreas Fault, and I talk to people all the time who have never even heard of the Rose Canyon Fault, and, you know, part of it might be due to the fact that we don't alert them or show them where that fault is.
This area right here, it wouldn't surprise me if today, if it started moving down by the Coronado Bridge, came through downtown, Old Town, here up to Mount Soledad, a 15-mile length, 6.4 magnitude earthquake, roughly speaking, could happen today without any trouble whatsoever. On the other hand, it might be 200 years away, but that's the part we don't know. as harmless as this looks, this is a killer right before your eyes.
So as we wait for that quake, back where we started at Faultline Park, you can visit a public art project that will help you keep an eye on any movement on this fault, however small.
I really like this installation here at Faultline Park. This big sphere with a viewing tube right through the center goes across the active fault and lines up with the sphere over there. If you look through the center of this sphere here, the idea is, well, when the fault moves, the spheres will no longer line up. And you know, this is a great art installation, but you know, we geologists have been doing this for over 150 years, planting instruments on either side of a fault to try to catch the creep movement that takes place or the amount of total offset in a big earthquake. So here's art imitating science.
So if all this earthquake talk has got you motivated to prepare yourself for a disaster, visit readysandiego.org. Run by the county's Office of Emergency Services, the site provides everything you need to get yourself ready for a natural disaster that hopefully is many, many years off. In the County News Center, I'm Dominic Fulgoni.